بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون. صدق الله العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الأمين الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. My dear brothers, elders, sisters, youngsters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Amongst one of the verses which was recited today in today's recitation, as we finish Surah Al-A'raf, one verse we recited regarding the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and regarding how we have to show respect to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how we have to always remain respectful and obedient towards the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those people, inshallah, who will hear the commentary of this verse today, inshallah ta'ala, when you go home tonight and whenever you hear the recitation of the Quran, you will realize the importance of respecting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A verse which translates as follows: Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, that when the Quran is recited, listen attentively and remain silent so that Allah's blessings descend upon you. And the commentators, they say regarding this verse, we begin with the commentary of Imam Jalaluddin As-Suyuti rahimahullah ta'ala, who beautifully explains that this verse, although it was revealed regarding how we have to abstain from talking and communicating during salah and during the khutbah, but nowadays, sometimes when we are giving the khutbah, we see that people continue that communication. Likewise, sometimes when the imam is reciting in salah and some people come in, they still continue their communication. So I feel that there is a very important need for us to understand this verse, because we do not want to become amongst those who are disrespecting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if you disrespect the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you are in essence disrespecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the one who disrespected Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was Iblis, when he did not listen to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Aba wastakbar, that Iblis and the devil, he declined the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he continued with his pride. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then said, then we made him from amongst the kafirin, from amongst the ones who deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So sometimes when you disrespect, you become amongst those who neglect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or who neglect the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Suyuti rahimahullah ta'ala, he says that although this verse was revealed regarding the prohibition of communicating and speaking during the khutbah and during when the imam recites in salah, however, Imam Suyuti rahmatullahi alayhi also mentions in the end of this commentary that وَقِيلَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ مُطْلَقًا, this command of remaining silent, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not say, He does not say here in this Quran, He does not say in this verse that you should remain silent. He's saying remain silent. It's an imperative, an order. There's a difference when someone says you have a choice of remaining silent, and there's a difference when someone says remain silent. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using an imperative, it's a command here. So Imam Suyuti rahmatullahi alayhi mentions that this command by Allah of remaining silent applies whenever you are listening to the recitation of the Holy Quran. Even if your child is reciting the Quran at home, you should remain silent. And if you can't remain silent, then you go into another room. If the Quran is playing in your car, you should remain silent. Why? Because your voice cannot be raised over the voice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not even like the companions' voices being raised over the voice of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, he said, whoever raises their voices above the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then they have destroyed their deeds. And when someone destroys his or her deeds, that means that you have changed from becoming a mu'min to a non-believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this verse, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنِ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ. He's commanding us, فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْصِتُوا. He's saying, first listen attentively. And listening attentively means that you stop whatever you're doing and you listen. And if you don't want to listen, then you exit and you continue doing what you're doing. وَأَنْصِتُوا. Look, first Allah says, listen attentively. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He applies more emphasis. He says, وَأَنْصِتُوا. Even if you can't even listen, then at least remain silent, be quiet. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. So that Allah's blessings descend upon you. And if you don't listen attentively, and if you don't remain silent, then what is the opposite of Allah's rahmah? The opposite of Allah's rahmah is His anger. His anger will descend upon you. So would you like Allah's anger, His wrath to descend upon you? Or would you like His rahmah, His mercy to descend upon you? Moving further on regarding the commentary of this verse, Imaduddin ibn Kathir rahmatullahi alayhi, his tafsir, he also mentions the commentary of this verse, and he mentions a very beautiful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But moreover, before that, he also mentions that how one of the tabi'een, they mention that whenever the imam is reciting a verse, because sometimes when the imam is reciting, either you're behind the imam praying behind him, either you're outside. So whenever you hear the imam reciting a verse, a fearful verse, or a verse about mercy, no one is allowed to say anything. And you have to remain silent. And thereafter, Hafidh ibn Kathir rahmatullahi alayhi mentions how Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahmatullahi alayhi records a hadith that is narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, قَالَ نَبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمَ مَنِ اسْتَمَعَ إِلَىٰ آيَةٍ مِّنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ. Whoever listens attentively whoever listens attentively to the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no specialization here regarding if you're listening to the verses in salah, or if you're listening at home, or if you're listening in the car, or if you're listening in another gathering. There's no specific mentioning here of the place of recitation. The hadith states that whoever listens attentively to the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the verses of the book of Allah, the verses of the Quran, كَتَبَتْ لَهُ حَسَنَةً مُضَاعَفَةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala writes a hasana for that person. Which type of hasana? Allah writes a good deed for that person. Which type of good deed? Just one good deed? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala writes a deed which is multiplied. Now, how much is that deed multiplied? Allahu wa rasuluhu a'lam. Only Allah knows. And remember, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings have no limit. So when Allah is multiplying something, then that multiplication is beyond any multiplication that we can do with our calculators. So if you listen to the book of Allah, if you listen to the verses of Allah attentively, carefully, then Allah writes a good deed for you, a type of deed which is multiplied. How much times is it multiplied? We don't even know, because it's so much. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned that what else happens to that person who listens to the verses of the Quran attentively? Whoever listens, you get a good deed written. For example, imagine if you don't know even how to recite the Quran, and you're just listening. So just by coming here and listening, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is writing such a good deed for you that is multiplied so much that we don't even know the number. But what happens if you recite the Quran? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَمَنْ تَرَاهَا كَانَتْ لَهُ نُورًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامِ. Whoever recites the verses of the Quran, then these verses that he is reciting, they will be a means of illumination for him on the Day of Judgment. They will become nur for him on the Day of Judgment. But think about it, even just by listening, Allah is giving you so much. Moving further on, let's look at the tafsir of Abu Hayyan al-Andalusi, rahimahullah ta'ala, al-Bahr al-Muhit, who mentions something very important. He mentions the adab of the Quran. And he says that this verse is not just for the khawas. This verse is not just for the khutbah or salah. He says this verse is for everyone. For any place, wherever the Quran is being recited. And he says that it is wajib on everyone who is gathered in the majlis of the recitation of the Quran that he remains silent or she remains silent. And he beautifully mentions that when Allah says listen attentively, he says that when even the non-believers, the kuffar, even when they listen attentively, the Quran sometimes becomes a means of rahmah for them in a way that they accept Islam just by listening to the recitation of the Quran. But if we as Muslims cannot even listen attentively to the Book of Allah, then what will happen when non-Muslims are seeing this and observing this? Imagine how they will feel when they observe us and they see that how we are disrespecting the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he further mentions that it's very important that you listen to the Quran attentively. And he says regarding the believers, whenever they listen attentively, what happens to them? Then they gain so much mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the mercy descends upon them and that mercy is seen through them. The nur is seen through them. Let's finish inshallah with the tafsir of Imam Alusi Baghdadi rahmatullahi alayhi ruh al-ma'ani, who mentions, he mentioned something amazing. And this is in fact the conclusion of today's tafsir. And inshallah this will change our attitude towards the Quran and the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes we start thinking we are so big compared to the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes we need to realize who we are. And if we are disrespecting the Book of Allah, then we need to realize and rectify our mistakes. Imam Alusi rahmatullah alayhi mentions, he says that in this verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when the Quran is recited, listen attentively and remain silent so that Allah's blessings descend upon you. Imam Alusi rahmatullah alayhi mentions that from this verse is a proof about the esteemed and honorable status of the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And no one can run away from this. No one can hide the status of the Quran. And this is why he says that some people they say, Ba'd al-Ashab, they say that it is mustahab that when any person is beginning to recite the Quran, it is mustahab that whenever you recite the Quran, out of salah, that you wear beautiful clothes. And you recite beautifully. And you sit facing the Qibla. Why? So that you give respect to the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nowadays we are living in a society, people are putting Qur'ans on the floor. People are opening and closing the pages of the Qur'an like it's a newspaper. This is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone turns the page of the Quran disrespectfully, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish him. And those people who want to memorize the Quran, those people who want the knowledge of the Quran, you first of all need to respect the Quran, you kiss the Quran, you put the Quran in your heart, on your head. And this is why, my dear brothers and sisters, before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions how when the verses are recited in the presence of the believers, their iman increases. Before he mentions this verse, he mentioned this verse. That when the Quran is recited, listen attentively and remain silent. Why? Because if you don't remain silent and if you do not listen carefully and attentively, then your iman is not going to increase. In fact, it will decrease. So before mentioning the importance of the Quran and before mentioning the qualities of the Quran and the feeling of the Quran, the atmosphere of the Quran, Allah tells us the adab and the respect of the Quran. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who always show respect towards the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant our children the knowledge of the Quran, the true respect of the Quran. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to illuminate our hearts with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who listen to the Quran carefully so that good deeds are written in our accounts. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that whenever we recite the Quran, this Quran becomes a means of illumination and nur for us on the Day of Judgment. Ameen Rabbil Alameen wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. مولاي صل
وسلم دائما
أبدا على حبيبك
خير الخلق كلهم.
الحمد لله منشئ الخلق. مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا. يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرام. مولاي صل وسلم دائما على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك البيت كلهم.
اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا محمد. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى ال سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه وعلى اله. والصلاه والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى اليك واصحابك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله. والصلاه والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى اليك واصحابك يا شفيع الله. والصلاه والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى اليك واصحابك يا رحمه للعالمين. اللهم ربنا تقبل منا انك انت السميع العليم. تب علينا يا مولانا انك انت التواب الرحيم. يا الله بالرجال يا الله جدنا بهذين يا الله يا پاک مسجد میں تشریف فرما ہوں گے. اللہ سب کی نیک تمناؤں کے ارادوں کو پورا فرما, سب کی گناہوں کو معاف فرما, سب کی اعلیٰ عبادتوں کو قبول منظور فرما, سب کے گھروں میں رحمت و برکتوں کا نزول فرما, سب کے کاروبار میں اللہ ان کے رزق میں وسعت یا برکت عطا فرما, ان کی اولاد کو نیک اور صالح بنا, جو بھی اولاد ان کو نیک اور صالح اولاد عطا فرما, جو بیمار ہیں ان کو شفا کامل عاجلہ عطا فرما, جو پریشان حال ان کی پریشانی کو دور فرما, جو مشکلات میں ان کی مشکلات کو آسان فرما. اللہ جتنے بھی مرحومین ہیں ہمارے ہم سب کے علام سب کے مرحومین کو جنت الفردوس میں مقام عطا فرما. ہمارے بھائی علاء الدین صدیقی صاحب بیمار ہیں, اللہ ان کو شفا کامل عطا فرما. امت مسلمہ میں اللہ جتنے بیمار ہیں سب کو شفا کامل عطا فرما. ہمارے مشائخ یا اللہ کو یا ہمارے مشائخ کی درجات بلند فرما, ان کا سایہ ہم پر دادے قائم و دائم فرما. اس مسجد کو یا اللہ جلاد یا اللہ ترقی عطا فرما. اس کے یا اللہ خادمین کی درجات بلند فرما. جو لوگ یا اللہ تسلسل سے آ رہے ہیں یا اللہ باوجود اس گرمی کے یا اللہ ان کے درجات بلند فرما. ہم سب کا یا اللہ قرآن پڑھنا اور سننا قبول منظور فرما. صلی اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ سیدنا محمد وعلیٰ آلہ وصحبہ اجمعین برحمتک یا ارحم الراحمین. لا الہ الا اللہ.